If you could sound like anyone, sing like anyone, who would it be? Maybe Luciano Pavarotti? Dr. Ingo Titze, a physicist in the Department of Speech Pathology at the University of Iowa, says he's developed a way to make a computer, a supercomputer, sound just like the great tenor himself. Professor Titze, can we hear your Pavarotti?
Okay. That was a piece.
A very sensitive interpretation, too.
You can see that the articulation is not what it should be, but I think we've got the vowels pretty well.
Professor, you call your computer model Pavarobotti?
Pavarobotti, yes.
How is it different from, say, a kind of the digitalized computer voices that we hear on something like directory assistance?
Well, what we do is we try to model the whole physics of the production mechanism. So we begin with lung pressures. We model the vibrations of the vocal folds. We model the airflow and the acoustic waves as they bounce back and forth. And so the purpose of this is not really so much to make believable sounds, but to learn a lot about what goes on inside, because we deal with professional voices, and we want to help them maintain those voices in the best shape.
What is that property of the human voice which, in a sense, is most difficult to mimic or to simulate?
The articulation. The timing that's involved in moving around the tongue, the lips, the soft palate, and those things. In my synthesis, I do a pretty good job in getting the vowels, but to put a string of words together while the singing goes on, that's the toughest part. But it'll be solved in the future.
Now, your interest in this is not to produce a lot of cheap Pavarotti recordings, but it's something else, isn't
Absolutely.
It?
Absolutely. We want to learn what principles are involved in making good solid sound productions for long periods of time without fatiguing. And by studying the mechanism of how that's done, I think we have a window into that.
Not that we aren't enjoying talking to you, but could we hear from Pavarobotti once more?
Is it okay if I do a little series here where he sings, I sing, and then he finishes off?
We will explain that you are an accomplished tenor singer in your own right, and I gather next month you're going to be singing a duet with Pavarobotti.
That's right. We'll just do a little snippet of that right now. Well, that's our big finale here.
You guys are great, Professor Titze, really. You ought to go on the road with this. Does Luciano Pavarotti, do you have any reason to think that he knows that you're using his voice this way?
I don't know. I had a conversation with his dentist in New York when I presented this at the Juilliard School just for fun a couple of years ago, and he said he would tell him about it, in fact, would invite me to his birthday party, but it never happened. Luciano, I think, couldn't come, as he often can't, so I don't know if he knows or not.
Now, it was Pavarobotti who was holding that note for such an extraordinary length of time.
Absolutely. It's not Titze. I can't do it for the life of me.
I wonder if Pavarotti could do it for the life of him.
Yeah, I obviously exaggerated that. I think the whole note was held for about 20 seconds. We could hold it for an hour if we had to.
But on the other hand, does a computer holding that note for that length of time bring tears to your eyes?
Well, that's a good question. Emotions are such fragile things. It depends on the mood of the audience, what have you, so I'll withhold firm judgment on that. I don't think in my lifetime a computer will ever thrill the public the way Luciano does, but we sure want to maintain what he has given us about voice and build it into as many, many kind of experiments and ways that we can learn about voice as we can.
Well, Professor Titze, thank you very much for speaking with us.
My pleasure, indeed.
Dr. Ingo Titze, physicist in the Department of Speech Pathology at the University of Iowa in Iowa City. Dr. Titze has developed a supercomputer model for the human larynx. It's called Pavarobotti. But we'll end with the real thing.